Osama is just one of Syria's 600,000 refugees.
The situation in Syria is very bad, very dangerous. President Assad destroyed everything. He destroyed homes. I live in homes. He destroyed the city, and most of them have no work, no food, no water, no electricity. They are in a bad situation now.
According to the UN, these refugees are spread across Turkey, Lebanon, and Jordan. Now some of those refugees and their children are finding relief. Some churches in Jordan are trying to redeem the tragedy in Syria, and many of these Syrian refugees here are experiencing the love of Christians for the very first time.
They said, "You're dealing with us like a human."
This pastor reaches out to hundreds of these refugees. It's dangerous work, so we hid his identity for security reasons.
Take this opportunity to show the light inside the darkness. The people go outside Syria. They're hopeless, and also before they didn't have chance to listen about the gospel or about Jesus. But right now we have the chance to show them the love and mercy and our faith through what we do for them.
Their help includes hot meals, church services for the children, and clothes for families who often have nothing but what is on their backs. Some of these children went from conditions like this to this. And there are opportunities to talk with someone about their situation. Many of these Muslim women, some now widowed, would not have stepped inside a church in Syria.
They didn't allow anybody to talk with them about Jesus. But here, because they are in need, and we don't want to say that we are using their needs, but while we feeding them and taking care of them, there is opportunity to share the love of God, which is more important than the food and than the clothes. So we are caring about their souls as we care about their bodies.
It's a ministry Osama appreciates.
We need it. It's good for us right now because we didn't have any work. We need all the help we can get. It makes a difference for us right now.
Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jordan.